Well, good evening, everyone.
Buenos tardes a todos.
We're so glad that you've joined us this evening for our Bible study.
Estamos alegre que se ha unido con nosotros para nuestro estudio bíblico.
We are going through a series.
Estamos aprendiendo lecciones de un series.
On infinitely more.
Que se llama infinitamente más.
This is a lesson that is describing how much you and I have as Christians.
Podemos aprender qué tanto tenemos en Cristo como cristianos.
We have more than we even fully realize.
Es mucho más de lo que entendemos.
Our theme this evening is entitled Foundation.
La tema de esta noche es Fundamento.
And with any building,
con cualquier edificio,
it has to have a foundation to build upon.
Tiene que tener un fundamento para hacer el edificio.
And so our lesson today is going to revolve around a firm foundation.
Y nuestra lección va a hablar acerca de un fundamento fuerte.
And so if we want to have all that God has for us.
Si usted y yo queremos todo lo que Dios tiene para nosotros,
we need to build upon that foundation which truly is Christ.
Necesitamos construir sobre ese fundamento cuál es Jesucristo.
The title of the lesson this evening,
el título de la lección es
Hold the Line.
Aférrese a la línea.
Hold the Line.
Aférrese a la línea.
And so our key verse has been Ephesians chapter 3, verse 20.
Nuestro verso clave ha sido Efesios 3, 20.
And I'm going to read it from the New Living Translation in English. And it says, "Now all glory to God, who is able through his mighty power at work within us to accomplish infinitely more than we might ask or think."
Al que puede hacer muchísimo más que todo lo que podemos imaginarnos o pedir por el poder que obra eficazmente en nosotros.
This is our third week of study.
Este es el tercera semana de nuestro estudio.
And over the past 2 weeks,
sobre los últimos semanas pasados,
we've been discovering that our life in Christ is infinitely more than we even realize.
Hemos descubrido que nuestra vida tiene infinitamente más en Jesucristo.
God is preparing us for it, and he's actually calling us to it.
Dios nos está llamando a una vida infinitamente más.
He's calling ordinary people like you and me.
Dios está llamando a personas comunes como nosotros.
To a life that is beyond anything we might ever ask or think.
A una vida que es superior a cualquier cosa que podemos pedir o imaginar.
And so as we follow Jesus,
mientras que seguimos a Jesús,
he will teach us how we are to live this extraordinary life.
Él nos enseñará cómo vivir esta vida extraordinaria.
And so he lays a foundation from which we can build upon.
Jesucristo hace el fundamento el cual vamos a construir.
Just as Jesus was beginning his ministry,
cuando Jesús comenzaba su ministerio,
there was a time we read in Matthew chapter 5.
Leemos en Mateo 5 que había un tiempo
that all the crowds were gathering to listen to Jesus.
Que los multitudes se acercaban para escuchar sus enseñanzas.
And so Jesus climbed upon a mountainside.
Jesús subió sobre un monte.
And he began to teach them there.
Y empezó a enseñarles.
This sermon was known as the Sermon on the Mount.
Es muy conocida. Se llama el Sermón del Monte.
It's Matthew chapters 5 through 7.
Se halla en Mateo capítulo 5 hasta el 7.
In the first part of chapter 5,
en el primer parte de capítulo 5,
Jesus began with what is called the Beatitudes.
Jesús empezó con una enseñanza que se llama las bienaventuranzas.
This was a list of blessings that follow a very specific way of living and thinking.
Era una lista de bendiciones que describían una manera muy específica de vivir y pensar.
This, again, is a specific plan.
Era un plan específica.
A list of blessings.
Una lista de bendiciones.
That will happen if we will follow that particular path.
Que van a cumplirse si seguimos el plan de Dios.
I'm going to read Matthew chapter 5, verses 3 through 12.
Lee conmigo en Mateo 5, versos 3 al 12.
I'll read it in English and you can follow in Spanish.
Él lo va a leer en inglés y vamos a seguir en nuestras Biblias de español.
It says, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they shall be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted because of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people insult you, persecute you, and falsely say all kinds of evil against you because of me. Rejoice and be exceeding glad, because great is your reward in heaven. For in the same way they persecuted the prophets who were before you." This is a beautiful portion of scripture that Jesus shared on the mountainside.
Esto es una bonita porción de escritura que Jesús les dijo en el monte ese día.
Here he lays out a plan for Christian living.
Jesús les presentó con un plan de cómo vivir en ser cristianos.
All of us want to be blessed.
Todos nosotros queremos ser bendecidos.
We want the blessing of God upon our lives, our ministries.
Queremos que Dios bendiga nuestras vidas, nuestros ministerios.
Upon our families and all that we do.
Y nuestra familia y sobre todo lo que hacemos.
And so Jesus, in his life,
en la vida de Cristo,
was fulfilling the law of God.
Él estaba cumpliendo la ley de Dios.
And as he was doing this, he was leading us.
Y también nos estaba enseñándonos cómo vivir.
And so Jesus, throughout this Sermon on the Mount,
en el mensaje que enseñó en el monte ese día,
he dealt with many issues.
Él habló acerca de una diversidad de enseñanzas.
He talked about fasting and prayer.
Él habló de oración y el ayuno.
And other issues he talked about.
Y mucho más.
But then at the end of chapter 7,
pero al fin del capítulo 7,
the people were blown away at the teaching of Jesus.
La gente se sorprendió a lo que dijo Jesús.
In Matthew chapter 7, verse 28,
en Mateo 7, verso 28,
it says they were astonished at his teaching.
Dice que la gente se fueron asombrados sobre las enseñanzas de Jesús.
They were amazed.
Estaban asombrados.
No one had ever taught like Jesus.
Nadie había enseñado como Jesucristo.
Put yourself there on that mountainside.
Póngase usted mismo en lugar de la, como las personas que estuvieron ahí ese día.
Imagine the way that Jesus would have spoken.
Imagínese como usted hubiera escuchado a Jesús predicar.
And that anointing of the Spirit upon him.
Él tenía la unción del Espíritu Santo sobre él.
And that would have made his words very captivating.
Y querían escuchar cada palabra.
In the latter part of chapter 7,
en el último parte de Mateo 7,
Jesus spoke a parable.
Jesucristo habló una parábola.
About the wise and the foolish builders.
De el constructor sabio y el necio.
In Matthew 7, verses 24 through 27.
Mateo 7, versos 24 a 27, dicen.
We're going to read this parable. And it says, therefore, everyone who hears these words of mine and puts them into practice is like a wise man who built his house on the rock. The rain came down, the streams rose, and the winds blew and beat against that house. Yet it did not fall, because it had its foundation on the rock. But everyone who hears these words of mine and does not put them into practice is like a foolish man who built his house on the sand. The rain came down, the streams rose, the winds blew and beat against that house, and it fell with a great crash. This parable is discussing those that were wise and foolish.
Esta parábola habla acerca de el hombre que era sabio y uno que era necio.
This is a great word picture in the scripture.
Esto es un gran metáfora o imagen de palabra.
The idea of building a house.
Enseñando la idea de construir una casa.
And this is very applicable to our lives as Christians.
Y como cristianos, esta palabra se puede aplicar a nuestras vidas.
Our lives are being built.
Nuestras vidas están siendo construidos.
And we're being built upon the foundation of Christ.
Sobre el fundamento de Jesucristo.
You see, our lives as Christians doesn't just happen automatically.
Esto no pasa automáticamente.
Rather, our faith, as it's growing.
Pero como está creciendo nuestra fe.
Is being built one decision at a time.
Se está construyendo un momento sobre otro.
It's being built upon multiple moments and multiple decisions in our faith journey.
Si no, se construye sobre una diversidad de momentos y decisiones en nuestra experiencia de fe.
And so we're building in our Christian faith.
En nuestra fe cristiana.
We're building upon that foundation, here a little, there a little.
Estamos construyendo un poco aquí y un poco en adelante.
As we're growing in Christ, we are making decisions.
Mientras que estamos creciendo en Cristo.
We're learning how to live like Christ.
Estamos aprendiendo cómo vivir como Él.
And so Jesus wants to make sure we build a secure and immovable foundation.
Él quiere que construimos sobre un fundamento seguro y inamovible.
As with any builder.
Como cualquier constructor.
Builders use tools to build appropriately.
Ellos usan herramientas de construcción.
These tools are important to do the work right.
Estas herramientas son muy importantes.
And one of the tools the scripture teaches about.
Una herramienta que la escritura habla
is the plumb line.
Es la plomada.
The plumb line was a tool used by builders to build straight buildings.
La plomada se usaba por los que construían edificios para hacer la línea derecho.
Straight walls.
Rectos paredes.
Things that would need to be even.
Para hacer que tendría todo uniforme.
And God used this tool to communicate his plans to Amos.
Y Dios habló sobre esta herramienta, el plomada, para hablar con el profeta Amos.
He used this to show the prophet Amos of staying in line with his commands.
Para enseñarle cómo seguir recto en sus leyes y en sus planes.
And so in Amos chapter 7, verses 7 through 9,
en Amos 7, versos 7 a 9,
we read about the plumb line.
Leemos sobre la plomada.
Notice what the scripture says.
Fíjese lo que dice la escritura.
This is Amos the prophet speaking.
El profeta Amos dice aquí,
then he showed me another vision. I saw the Lord standing beside a wall that had been built using a plumb line. He was using a plumb line to see if it was still straight. And the Lord said to me, Amos, what do you see? I answered, a plumb line. And the Lord replied, I will test my people with this plumb line. I will no longer ignore all their sins. The pagan shrines of your ancestors will be ruined, and the temples of Israel will be destroyed. I will bring the dynasty of King Jeroboam to a sudden end. You can read that one in Spanish.
Luego me mostró otra visión. Vi al Señor de pie al lado de una pared que se había construido usando una plomada. Usaba la plomada para ver si aún estaba derecha. Entonces el Señor me dijo, Amos, ¿qué ves? Una plomada. Plomada, contesté. Y el Señor respondió, probaré a mi pueblo con esta plomada. Ya no pasaré por alto sus pecados. Los altares paganos de sus antepasados quedarán en ruinas, y los santuarios de Israel serán destruidos. Acabaré de forma repentina con la destina del rey Jeroboam.
What's interesting is we must realize that this illustration of using the plumb line,
esta ilustración aquí de usar la plomada,
was given over 2,000 years ago.
Fue escrita hace más de 2,000 años.
And yet there's not a job site anywhere in the world.
Sin embargo, no hay lugar de trabajo en el mundo
that doesn't utilize the concept of the plumb line.
Que también no conozca el concepto de usar la plomada.
The plumb line makes sure everything is straight in line.
La plomada es usada para confirmar que todo está recto y derecho.
This is how the builder knows that the wall is straight.
Así el que está construyendo sabe que el pared está derecho.
We expect the builders to build straight walls.
Queremos que cada constructor haga las paredes derechos.
We don't expect things to be unlevel.
No queremos que no van a trabajar si los paredes no están derechos.
And so the plumb line is a necessary tool.
Y la plomada es un método necesario.
God was speaking to Amos.
Dios aquí le estaba hablando a Amos.
That he would use the plumb line.
Que él iba a usar la plomada.
To make sure that they were walking that straight path.
Para probar al pueblo, para ver si andaban derechos.
You see, God has a plan for our lives as Christians.
Como cristianos, Dios tiene un gran plan para nosotros.
And we must follow God's plan.
Y tenemos que seguir el plan de Dios.
And as we do, we will be blessed.
Y vamos a ser bendecidos.
Our lives will begin to experience the blessing of God.
En nuestras vidas vamos a experienciar las bendiciones de Dios.
We will understand what it is to receive infinitely more.
Y vamos a entender lo que es recibir infinitamente más.
God even spoke about the plumb line to Isaiah the prophet.
Dios también habló al profeta Isaías acerca de la plomada.
In Isaiah 28:17, it says, I will test you with the measuring line of justice and the plumb line of righteousness.
Isaías 28:17 dice, los probaré con la cuerda de medir de la justicia y con la plomada de la rectitud.
A plumb line is an interesting tool.
La plomada es un instrumento interesante.
It has a weight at the bottom.
Tiene algo pesado abajo.
And it's tied to a string.
Y está conectado a una cuerda.
This string that is weighted down by this weight.
La cuerda que tiene algo pesado abajo.
As they hang it in the air.
Mientras que lo colgan en el aire.
That weight will cause that string to be totally straight.
Ese peso va a hacer que la cadena o la cuerda se haga derecho.
There will be a perfectly straight line from top to bottom.
Y hace una línea perfecto.
And so God has a perfect plan.
Y Dios tiene perfecto plan.
And what this is speaking to us.
Y nos habla a nosotros.
Is that there's only one way to follow him.
Que solamente hay una manera en seguirle.
It's a straight path.
Es un camino recto, derecho.
And so we must set our boundaries to be built upon that line.
Y debemos de asegurar las límites para seguir a ese plan.
If we stay committed to the line that God has drawn, we will be blessed.
Si nos mantenemos firmes a la línea que Dios ha planeado para nosotros, seremos bendecidos.
You will be protected.
Estaremos protegidos.
And you will be blessed with God's leading in your life.
Y Dios mismo nos guiará.
But the moment we step off of that line.
Pero si nos desviamos de esa línea.
We're breaking the ties of that relationship that we have with God.
Romperemos los lazos de esa relación que tenemos con Cristo.
And in a sense, we're stepping out of God's protection.
Y en esa manera estamos andando afuera de la protección de Cristo.
We will lose God's guidance.
Pierderemos la guianza.
And he won't bless us.
Y también pierderemos la bendición.
You see, God's not going to bless sin.
Dios no puede bendecir al pecado.
But when we are walking right with God.
Pero cuando andamos bien con Dios.
We can expect the blessing of God.
Podemos esperar las bendiciones y ayudas de Dios.
And so we must understand that God wants us to walk in his way.
Dios quiere que andemos en su camino.
When we do,
cuando lo hacemos,
we will be in the blessing of God.
Vamos a estar seguros en la bendición de Dios.
Just like the plumb line in building a structure.
Así como la línea de la plomada es crucial para construir.
This little tool provides a line that is very accurate.
Esta línea provee algo muy precisa.
And so God has been showing us his way since the times of the Old Testament.
Dios nos ha enseñado su camino desde el Antiguo Testamento.
He's teaching us how to have a relationship with him.
Nos está enseñando cómo tener una relación con él.
And this is brought to its greatest fulfillment in Christ Jesus.
Y esto pasa definido en seguir a Jesucristo.
The plumb line again is perfectly straight.
La plomada ofrece una línea perfecto.
And from this Sermon on the Mount.
Y de el mensaje en el monte.
Jesus has drawn a line for us to know how that we should live for him.
Jesucristo mostró cómo vivir por él con una línea.
As said earlier, we all want to be blessed.
Como dije antes, todos queremos ser bendecidos.
And he showed us how.
Y nos enseñó cómo.
He drew a line.
Él mostró, enseñó cómo está la línea.
And so the only way for us to go towards the blessing of God.
La única manera de ir acerca del plan de Dios
is to hold the line.
Es de afarecernos a la línea.
What that represents
lo que representa
is staying in line with God and others.
Es de afarecernos perfectos en la línea con Dios y también otros.
Now here's the problem.
Pero aquí hay un problema.
Well, Jesus wants us to stay connected to that line.
Jesucristo quiere que mantengamos quiere que me mantenga conectado a la línea.
Satan wants to lure us away from the line.
Pero Satanás quiere que nos alejamos.
He wants to get us out of alignment.
Él quiere arruinar esta protección.
He wants us to get away from the will of God for our lives.
También quiere arruinar el plan de Dios para nuestras vidas.
And so the moment Satan gets us away from walking that line,
el momento que Satanás gane en destruir esa afareza a la línea,
the rest will begin to just happen.
Lo demás también se va a seguir destruyendo.
One sin becomes more sin.
Un pecado sigue con otro pecado.
Then more sin becomes even more sin.
Y otro pecado a otro pecado.
It's just like church attendance.
Puede ser también como en atender a la iglesia.
You miss one Sunday.
Quizás no puedes ir un domingo.
It's easier to miss another Sunday.
Y el otro domingo es más fácil.
And if we're not careful,
y si no estamos cuidado de eso,
before you know it, we won't be going to church at all.
Se hace muy fácil ya no ir a la iglesia.
Even this online church that we're doing.
Y también estar conectados en línea.
We need to keep on that line.
Tenemos que guardar esa línea.
Or should I say, we need to be online.
O debo de decir, tenemos que mantenernos en línea.
In other words, we need to be committed to keeping God's line in our lives, God's plan in our lives.
En otras palabras, quiero decir que tenemos que ser firmes de seguir el plan de Dios.
Satan wants to lure us away from that line of God.
Satanás quiere que nos alejamos del plan de Dios.
And so we need to be aware of the enemy's devices.
Tenemos que estar alertos a las maneras que Satanás trabaja.
It just takes a little bit to begin to cause us to turn away.
Solamente empieza con algo pequeño.
It's like that straight line on a wall.
Como esa línea que está derecho y recto en el pared.
If that builder isn't following that straight line,
si el que está construyendo no sigue directo en esa línea perfecto,
as they begin to veer off that straight line,
en con compromiso a esa línea,
it'll eventually begin to seemingly be straight.
Se, quizás se aparece que está recto,
but it's crooked.
Pero no. Está recto.
The plumb line is straight up and down.
La plomada está derecho y recto.
But if it begins to veer off, it begins to go in a diagonal way.
Pero en no tenerlo perfecto, la línea no va a estar recto.
Even if it's just a little.
Aunque sea un poco.
It's still not straight.
No va a estar perfecto.
Satan can come to us with some juicy gossip.
Quizás Satanás puede venir para destruir con la chisme.
Someone that gets on our nerves.
Alguien que nos hace enojar.
And then before you know it, we're in a small group.
Y antes de saberlo,
And we're trying to use that prayer request time.
Y de repente usamos ese tiempo de peticiones.
To bring out how we saw Susan at a restaurant.
Para decir un chisme de cómo vimos a alguien, Susana.
She's at the restaurant.
Que estaba comiendo en el restaurante.
And looks like she has a few empty margarita glasses.
Y parece que ella tomó algunos vasos de cerveza.
And you want the group to pray for her drinking problem.
Y representas el petición que quieres el grupo que ore por ella.
But it's only to bring out that she was doing wrong.
Pero en verdad, este chisme hace que Susana se mire mal.
That gossip might not seem like an outright sin.
Quizás ese chisme no se parece directo como pecado.
But it's a small veering off the line. We're moving away from the line.
Pero es algo que nos retira de la línea perfecto.
Listen, Satan doesn't destroy our lives in one big moment.
Satanás no destruye nuestra vida en un gran y único momento.
No, it's small steps and small compromises.
Son los pasos pequeños y los compromisos pequeños.
It's those little compromises.
Esos compromisos pequeños.
That begin to cause us to think it's okay to live outside of the perfect will of God.
Que nos hace sentir cómodos viviendo afuera del perfecto voluntad y plan de Dios.
And the longer we stay in that course.
Mientras que seguimos en esa línea mal.
We risk losing all that we have in the Lord.
Vamos a perder todo lo que tenemos en estar en el plan de Dios.
We're beginning to go away from the line.
Nos salemos de la línea y plan perfecto.
And then when life begins to blow those storms of life into our lives.
Y cuando las tempestades de nuestra vida empiezan a venir sobre nosotros.
And that foundation is tested.
Y ese fundamento está probado.
If our foundation isn't built upon the Word of God.
Si nuestro fundamento no está edificado sobre la plan y la Biblia.
Then everything will crumble.
Todo se va a caer.
And so how do we keep ourselves from being pulled away from the line?
Entonces, ¿cómo evitamos alejarnos de la línea?
Well, number one.
Número uno.
We must hold tight to our commitment to God.
Aférrese a su compromiso con Dios.
We must be determined to walk that straight and narrow.
Tenemos que ser determinados a seguir esa línea perfecta con Dios.
We mustn't forget the plumb line that God has drawn for us.
No olvide la línea conplomada que Dios ha trazado para nosotros.
We must strengthen our commitment to God.
Fortalezca su vida en Cristo.
We must be consistent in our personal devotion to God.
Tenemos que guardarnos constantemente en nuestra vida de oración.
And of course, that means reading our Bibles.
Y también leyendo nuestras Biblias.
Being familiar with God's Word.
Familiarizarse con la palabra de Dios.
Keeping our prayer life intact.
Manteniendo nuestra vida en oración.
And as we do, we will remain committed to God.
Y vamos a ser victoriosos así.
That helps us to tighten our grip to that line.
Esto nos ayuda a aferrarnos en la línea de Dios.
Secondly,
segundo,
we must hold tight to our commitment to others.
Aférrese a su compromiso con los demás.
Hold tight to your commitment to others.
Aférrese a su compromiso con los demás.
You see, God hasn't called us to live all by ourselves.
Dios no nos ha llamado a vivir solitos.
We actually live among each other.
Vivimos en medio de gente.
And so we need to remember that we are a part of a body.
Y somos parte de un cuerpo.
And so the scripture says,
la escritura dice,
that we must be careful of not getting or getting angry or speaking evil against someone.
Cuidado, la tentación de enojarse y hablar mal contra alguien.
Remember the scripture says,
recuerda, la escritura dice,
blessed are the peacemakers.
Bienaventurados los pacificadores.
For they will be called the children of God.
Porque ellos serán llamados hijos de Dios.
When we're tempted to isolate,
cuando estamos tentados a separarnos de la gente,
we must remember,
recuerde,
that blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted.
Que la Biblia dice, bienaventurados los que lloran, porque ellos recibirán consolación.
When our family or those that we care for,
cuando nuestra familia o la gente que amamos,
when they don't understand why we decided to follow Jesus,
no entienden por qué hemos escogido seguir a Cristo,
or even old friends try to bring up our past,
o quizás nuestros amigos quieren sacar nuestro pasado,
we must remember,
recuerde,
blessed are those who are persecuted because of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven.
Bienaventurados los que padecen persecución por causa de la justicia, porque de ellos es el reino de los cielos.
We must commit to being faithful to church.
Necesitamos guardarnos fieles a la iglesia.
To those that are fellow believers.
A los hermanos y hermanas en el cristianismo.
And it's important to have a healthy accountability.
Y es importante seguir aferrado con nuestros amigos para seguir fieles.
So that we can talk to them if we're feeling tempted.
Para hablar con ellos si estamos pasando por un tiempo de tentación.
Or we're struggling and we need someone to pray for us.
O estamos en una batalla y necesitamos oración.
Someone that you can trust.
Alguien con quien puedes confiar.
Someone that will speak the truth to us.
Alguien que va a hablar la verdad de Dios.
See, God has given all of us abilities.
Dios nos ha dado a todos nosotros habilidades.
We are a part of a body.
Somos parte del cuerpo de Dios.
We need each other.
Y necesitamos el uno al otro.
And so thank God that there is the potential for infinitely more.
Y gracias a Dios que Él tiene infinitamente más para nosotros.
And we must build upon a proper foundation.
Vamos a construir sobre el perfecto fundamento de Dios.
God has given us a plumb line.
Tenemos la línea plomada perfecto.
And that plumb line helps us to know if we're walking straight or not.
Y esa línea nos ayuda a saber si estamos andando derechos y rectos.
We want all that God has for us.
Queremos todo de lo que Dios tiene para nosotros.
We want Him to bless us.
Queremos sus bendiciones.
And so we must go about our lives following His plan.
Y tenemos que seguir el plan de Dios.
It's really straight.
Es una línea derecho. Recto.
It's not hard to figure out.
No es difícil de saber cuál es la línea.
It's a straight and narrow way.
Es un camino derecho y recto.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So thank God for this series of Infinitely More.
Gracias a Dios por este series que se llama Infinitamente Más.
Let's close in a word of prayer.
Voy a orar.
I'm going to pray for those who feel like they are losing their grip to the line that God has given us.
Primero quiero orar por los que sienten que están cerca de soltarse de la línea.
We also want to pray for those who have totally fallen completely off the line.
Segundo quiero orar por los que se han alejado completamente de la línea.
We want to pray that God will bring them back to this line.
Vamos a orar que Dios les da la oportunidad de volver a aparecerse de la línea.
And lastly, we want to pray for those that are hearing the good news of Jesus for the very first time.
Y últimamente queremos orar porque quizás hay algunos que están escuchando estas buenas nuevas por primera vez.
They're discovering the line that he has drawn for them.
Y están descubriendo que Dios ha hecho una línea perfecta para ellos.
Amen.
Amen.
Let's pray.
Voy a orar.
Lord, I ask in the name of Jesus that you, Lord, would truly begin to minister to each and every heart, every life that is listening to our Bible study this evening. I pray, Lord, that you would help those, especially that feel like they're losing their grip upon that plumb line, that line that you have given for us to follow. I pray, Lord, that you would strengthen those that are struggling, that, Lord, you'd remind them that you want and it's your desire to help, to strengthen, to give the grace, the willingness to keep holding on to that line. And so I pray that you'd remove discouragement, remove those things that would be hindering in their lives. And Lord, we thank you that you will be faithful. Lord, it's hard in a time when we're cooped up in our houses. I pray that, Lord, they would begin to sense in their heart, their spirit, that, Lord, they are right where they need to be. I pray that, Lord, you would help everyone, especially when they're struggling or, Lord, when they feel like they've just messed up. I pray that you'd show them that you are for them, not against them. I pray for those that have totally turned, those that have completely fallen off the line, Lord, that you would speak to their hearts and show them that, Lord, it's your desire for them to walk in that straight and narrow way. That, Lord, all they have to do is come to you. They just have to repent of those things that have caused them to turn away. And, Lord, you will be glad to help them, to bring them back into your protection, to bring them back into the blessing that is found only in serving you. Draw their hearts through the power of the Holy Spirit. I pray in Jesus' name. And Lord, lastly, we pray. We pray for those that in hearing about, Lord, this plumb line and the foundation that we build in Christ, I pray that, Lord, if they've not opened their hearts to you, that they would understand your love for them. That, Lord, you do have a specific plan, a specific line that you want us to walk on. And I pray that you would help them to walk in that narrow way. I pray that they would turn from their wicked ways, turn to you with all of their hearts, and you will receive them. All they have to do is simply open their hearts and receive you into their lives. Turn from their manner of life that they've been living. Repent, and you will receive them. Put your hand upon them in Jesus' name. And I pray, Lord, through this lesson, through these lessons that we are studying, that we would begin to have our eyes opened to how much you have in store for us. Lord, it's exceeding and abundantly above all that we can ask or think. It's infinitely more. And so bring us to that place of extreme blessing. And I thank you, Lord, for all that we've learned in Jesus' name. Amen and amen.
Amen.
Well, thank you for joining us this evening.
Gracias por unirse con nosotros.
It's always such a blessing to join together, even if it's online.
Es un placer estar con usted, aunque sea en línea.
And so join us again on Sunday morning.
Por favor, únese otra vez más el domingo por la mañana.
It's going to be the first Sunday of the month.
Va a ser el primer domingo de el mes.
And so remember, we'll be taking up our offering for BGMC.
Vamos a colectar nuestra ofrenda por los misioneros BGMC.
And we'll also be just praying and believing God for one another.
Y esperando para todo lo que Dios va a hacer.
And so God bless you all.
Dios les bendiga.
And you all have a good evening.
Y tengan buena tarde.
God bless you.
Dios les bendiga.